To consider the structure of the factor market, it's important to remember that the firm is both a seller and a buyer, the seller of an output slash end product and the buyer of the resources used to make that product. Let's start with the easiest case, a firm that is operating in a perfectly competitive output market, i.e. there are a large number of firms selling the same product, and is buying its variable input in a perfectly competitive market. For example, there may be a large number of firms competing to buy labor. The firm can influence neither the price of its product nor the price it must pay for its variable input. It can purchase all the labor it wants at the going market wage without affecting that wage. Note that the going market wage is determined by the overall supply and demand in the labor market. So what can the firm decide? The firm cannot choose the wage that it pays to labor, but it can decide how much labor to hire. In this table, we can see the effect of increasing the number of workers on the firm's total output. The output rises, but at a slower and slower rate, reflecting the diminishing marginal product as more and more labor is hired, a phenomenon covered in episode number 20. As we defined it in episode 20, marginal product is the change in total product over the change in the resource, in this case, the added output as we add one more worker. Because we do not know the total output for 5 workers in this example, we cannot determine how much more output there is when we have 6 workers, but we can calculate the marginal product for each of the other workers by determining how much the total product has changed with each one. Again, once we've figured out the marginal product values, we can see the pattern of diminishing marginal product. But I digress somewhat. The original question was, how many workers will the firm hire? How will this firm, which must take the price of labor, that is the wage, as given, decide on how many workers to hire? Effectively, we just go right back to our old marginal revenue equals marginal cost profit maximizing rule, except that it's the added revenue and added cost of hiring another worker. The rule for hiring is that the firm hires workers up to the point where the additional cost of hiring the last worker is equal to the additional revenue generated by hiring that worker. Based on what we have so far, workers, total product, and marginal product, I still need some more information, specifically the marginal cost of hiring the last worker and the marginal revenue generated by that worker. How do I determine how much revenue is generated by hiring another worker? I can start by looking at the value of the marginal product, or the VMP, or the market value of the worker's marginal product, the price of the output times the extra output generated by that worker. The marginal revenue product, or MRP, the revenue added by the worker's marginal product, or marginal revenue times marginal product. From our experience with output market structures, episodes 25 through 30, we know that in most cases, price is greater than marginal revenue, so the value of the marginal product would be greater than the marginal revenue product. However, because we started with the assumption that the firm operates in a perfectly competitive output market, price is equal to marginal revenue, so the value of the marginal product, price times marginal product, and the marginal revenue product, marginal revenue times marginal product, are the same. Going back to the profit maximizing rule for hiring, remember that the added revenue from hiring another worker, which we now know as MRP, must be equal to the added cost of hiring another worker, or the marginal factor cost. Right now, we are still missing the marginal factor cost piece. The marginal cost of workers is the extra cost that is incurred in employing more of that factor of production. By definition, marginal factor cost, MFC, is equal to the change in total cost over the change in input. In a competitive labor market, i.e., firms compete with one another to hire workers, each unit of labor is hired at exactly the same rate, so MFC is constant and equal to the wage. As mentioned in the factor market overview, this line will also be the firm's supply of labor. So, let's add wage to the chart, say $4.98 per week. No matter how many workers the firm hires, this will be the wage. Because the wage is constant, each and every worker hired will add the same dollar amount to the cost, $498. Thus, marginal factor cost is the same as the wage. So now that we have all of the pieces, we can see that for this firm, marginal revenue product equals marginal factor cost at 12 workers. If the firm hires more workers past this point, then the marginal factor cost is greater than the value of the marginal product, and additional wages would not be covered by any addition to revenue. If the firm hires less workers, then value of the marginal product is greater than marginal factor cost, and the firm could be increasing profit by hiring more workers. Next time, perfectly competitive factor market, monopoly output market.